from the Atlantic states to the southern states. Hi, I'm Tom Terwilliger, along with my partner Steve Stone, and this month, the cameras of Muscle Sport USA take you to sunny Fort Lauderdale, Florida, for one of the most prestigious national qualifying events in the country, the Twin Lab NPC Southern States Bodybuilding and Fitness Championships.
Well, this is the first time that this event has been on our calendar, but I have been here before, and Tommy, I knew what to expect coming in. Over 100 top athletes vying for national recognition. And after seeing the earlier prejudging, I wasn't disappointed.
No question about it. The national recognition you're talking about comes from competing in front of nationally recognized judges, along with the National Physique Committee president himself, Jim Mannion, and of course the exposure from competing in front of the Muscle Sport USA cameras.
Well, the competitors here are very lucky in that sense, because the judges that are critiquing them here will be at all NPC national events.
No question, this will be great exposure for today's competitors. And talk about exposure, we'll be bringing you to Pennsylvania to see some of those athletes compete in the NPC Pittsburgh Bodybuilding Championships with Kenny Castle. All that's coming up and more on this month's edition of Muscle Sport USA.
You can climb a mountain or become one with new Pinnacle Creaglutide ADS, the next generation creatine supplement. Pinnacle Creaglutide bonds creatine with glutamine peptide for awesome muscle gains. Plus, its patented advanced delivery system extends benefits longer than any other creatine supplement. Pinnacle Creaglutide ADS. Get it in powder or tablets at Great Earth Vitamin Stores, GNC, and other fine health food stores and gyms.
Why choose designer protein? Not because bodybuilders have made it the number one selling protein powder in America today. Not because it was voted best tasting in an independent study. Choose it because designer protein is the only pure protein powder with WPH whey peptides, delivering up to 230% more nitrogen to your muscles and doing it up to 257% faster. These are the facts. Pick up your designer protein at GNC and other progressive health food stores and gyms.
Finally, the ultimate breakthrough in sports bar technology, Pure Protein from Worldwide Sport Nutrition, the first high-protein, low-carb nutrition bar ever developed. Pure Protein is the only bar packing 33 grams of protein with only 9 grams of carbs. Call now and order your box of 12 bars for only $39.95. Pure Protein, the complete meal in a bar from Worldwide Sport Nutrition, available at select GNCs, health food stores, and gyms worldwide.
For the last 5 years, I've had this dream.
Feed your dream with Twin Lab Creatine Fuel.
Don't wake me now.
Creatine Fuel from Twin Lab. Feed your dream. Feed the machine.
Muscle Sport USA is brought to you by Metrex Engineered Nutrition, rated number one in bodybuilding nutrition. Metrex is available at fitness and health food retailers everywhere. Designer Protein. Pick up a jar of America's best-selling protein at GNC and other progressive health food stores and gyms throughout all 50 states and Canada. Twin Lab, makers of creatine fuel and other high-performance sports nutrition products. Feed your dream. Feed the machine with Twin Lab. And by Audionics, makers of Creatoglutide with the patented ADS advanced delivery system.
Welcome back, bodybuilding and fitness fans, to the vacation paradise, Fort Lauderdale, Florida, where the athletes you'll be seeing here today haven't come to play in the surf, but to make some waves in one of the top regional bodybuilding and fitness events in the nation, the Twin Lab NPC Southern States Bodybuilding and Fitness Championship. I'm Tom Terwilliger, along with my partner Steve Stone, and we're here bringing you the action from the War Memorial Auditorium.
And after seeing that earlier prejudging, Tommy, this show is outstanding. Our first competitor in the women's lightweight division is Joyce Bernier. Joyce is 5'2", weighed in at 118 pounds, which puts her right at the top of this lightweight division. And Tommy, she looks fantastic.
Well, Steve, she creates a deceptive look When you see her stand up, as we saw her in the prejudging earlier, she looks much taller and really has a great lean physique.
Within your weight class, you usually look the same height because most people are around 5'2", which when you go up against those other weight classes, like you can really see that height difference.
Moving on in the women's lightweight division, our next competitor is only 30 years old. She's been training for 10 years at 5'1" and 102 pounds. Vicky Morrissey looks like she's got a shot in this division.
Tommy, if it wasn't for Joyce, I would definitely say you're right. 102 pounds is light. She needs to put on that extra muscle if she wants to step it up from here at the Southern States. She was the overall champion of the Mid-Florida Muscle last year. She knows how to compete. You can see her symmetry is excellent. Just to be a little bit sharper and to have that extra muscle, she can definitely step it up to the Nationals.
Steve, we always mention the Nationals. Is it truly the goal of every competitor to move to that level?
Well, maybe not to move up to that level, but definitely to have that much muscle to do it.
With more titles under her belt than I can list, our next competitor, Marla Rosello, at 5'5" and only 109 pounds, certainly has that goal, Steve.
Well, 5'5", Tommy, she should move up to the middleweights, but you can see here she's doing excellent at the Southern stage, which is very good. She is in definite contention for second place for different reasons than Vicky.
Let's move on to the women's pose down.
From right to left, in the red, we have Joyce Benear. In the blue, Vicky Morrissey. There we have, in the red, Christine Wan going up against Marla Rosello. And standing behind Joyce Bannock in the sparkle blue is Jacqueline Bannock.
Steve, now this is a relatively aggressive pose down for lightweight women, isn't it?
This is an aggressive pose down for any weight class, Tommy. And this is the first time, if you didn't see prejudging, that you will see these top five athletes standing on stage together. So now's the time to root for your favorite.
The audience is doing just that as our MC, Mike Katz, former Mr. Universe, announces the winner. Joyce Benear takes the women's lightweight division.
And after going to a tiebreaker, Marla Rosello in second place, Vicky Morrissey in third, fourth, Christine Wan, and fifth, Jacqueline Bannock.
Joyce will be back to challenge the other weight class winners later on in the show to capture the overall title. Our women's heavyweights are backstage warming up as our middleweights prepare to take the stage. The audience is loving this, Steve. We'll see three of our top finalists in the women's middleweight division pose here tonight. And the first is 35-year-old Juliana Comprendo, who is one of the standouts in this competition, as you mentioned earlier, Steve.
Well, she drove all the way down from Georgia. She has a past of doing very well in bodybuilding contests, Tommy. You don't come down here if you don't look this good, and she does. This is going to be a very tight contest between she and Kelly McCluskey.
Look at the muscle separation. You talk about the Nationals often. This woman looks like she's ready now.
At 5'7", Tommy, she's a little tall for the middleweight division, but you're absolutely right. She does have everything else it takes.
You might remember our next finalist from our broadcast of the Team Universe Championship last year. Cheryl Vasquez looks fabulous in today's show at 5'5", 122 pounds.
And as good as Cheryl looks here today, she is not peaked. Believe it or not, she is peaking for the Team Universe competition. This is a very gutsy move, knowing that everybody else in her weight class is here to win this title.
That's a difficult thing to do. First, enter one show and then peak for another. No need to wish Cheryl good luck now. The Muscle Sport USA camera, Steve and myself, will be at the Team Universe. We'll do it there. Our next competitor today doesn't need any luck. This is 26-year-old Kelly McCluskey at 5'4", 128 pounds. Looks awesome.
Last year, we had seen Kelly compete as a heavyweight at the Atlantic States Bodybuilding Championships, where she took fourth. You can see, dropping down to the middleweights, she looks a whole lot sharper. Her symmetry is excellent, and Tommy, she is definitely in contention, not only for this class, but for the overall title. She looks awesome.
Very poised on stage, nice control in terms of her posing, showing her best shape, and a fabulous side chest shot. Her poise should take her right to the Nationals. Right now, she's going to be joining the other competitors on stage as she receives support from the audience. What a fabulous group of middleweight champions on stage now.
You're right, Tommy. They have all won titles before, but there will only be one winner here today. Right here, we have Juliana Comprendo showing that back. She looks super next to Beth Eisenman. Kelly McCluskey's back. We're staring at it. Muscular, looks awesome.
Juliana's abdominals could almost win this show alone, but of course, you can't leave out Karen Aguilera and Cheryl Vasquez, also competing in the top five here. This is a fierce pose down. These women are giving 100% to this lineup. Audience waiting for this decision to come down anxiously as we are, and there it is. Kelly McCluskey, poised for this competition and to move on, takes the women's middleweight division.
In second, Juliana Comprindo. Third, Shella Vasquez. Fourth, Karen Aguilera. And fifth, Beth Eisenman.
Kelly will be in strong contention for this overall title when we come back, the women's heavyweight, right after this on Muscle Sport. Welcome back. We're here in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, known for its sunny beaches and swaying palms. Well, palms of another sort are coming together as we speak to cheer on the competitors in the women's heavyweight division of the Twin Lab NPC Southern States Bodybuilding and Fitness Championship. Hi, I'm Tom Twilliger, along with my partner Steve Stone, bringing you the action from the War Memorial Auditorium. The first of our three finalists in the women's heavyweight division is 36-year-old Carla Redo. Carla is 5'7", weighed in today at 140 pounds.
Carla was an All-American in basketball. The only reason I'm bringing that up is because it takes the same amount of dedication to get into this kind of shape, Tommy.
Well, she certainly has a disciplined physique. She's having fun on stage. I'm not crazy about the posing. It's a little sporadic, and perhaps it belongs on the dance floor. But listen, the audience is loving it, as they will our next competitor. This is Deborah Myers, 40 years old, or should I say young, weighed in today at 140 pounds at 5'7". This woman's a housewife who has found the time to put 3 years into training and is now enjoying the benefits.
And one of those benefits is actually having the whole nation look upon this physique, which is in good shape, Tommy. I'm going to say good because she needs to bring those lats up. She's a heavyweight competitor, and at the national level, when they hit that front double bicep, which is your first pose, they want to see those lats. They want to see that symmetry.
They may not see the lats on Deborah today, but she's certainly an inspiration to women her age and definitely ready for the Masters Nationals. The next finalist in the women's heavyweight division is 32-year-old Debbie Bryant. Debbie weighed in today at 160 pounds at 5'7". Look at the muscle on this woman.
3 years ago, she took fourth at the Junior National Bodybuilding Championships. You can see in those 4 years, she has put on some heavy-duty muscle, 160 pounds at 5'7". She is ready to move it up again, Tommy, and I think she would be top five if she tries.
Great shape, but Steve, she looks like she could use a little more separation, perhaps hardness. Debbie started training about 8 years ago, and she's taken it very, very seriously since.
I've been competing for 8 years. I've been training for 8 years. Before that, I was into sports, a lot of sports. Every type of sport you can think of as far as triathlons, tennis, racquetball, gymnastics, just crazy. And someone told me if I did one thing, I would do well at it. So I decided to bodybuild. And I did that, and I've been doing it for 8 years, and here I am.
Great philosophy. Don't put all your eggs in one basket, but if you're going to, make sure you're darn good at what you pursue. Ready to accept the judge's decision, the three finalists in the women's heavyweight division are now on stage together.
In the pink, we have Debbie Bryant, our favorite, but the strong contest is for second between Carla Redo and Deborah Myers.
All women are looking good on stage now, and there it is, our winner of the women's heavyweight division, Debbie Bryant.
Carla Redo takes second place by 1 point over Deborah Myers.
Great competition by all of our heavyweights. And of course, Debbie Bryant will be back later on to compete against our other weight class winners for the overall title. And that's coming up next right here on Muscle Sport USA.
If you lift weights, you're probably already familiar with the benefits of creatine supplementation. You may even be familiar with some of the problems associated with its use. Regardless of your experience, you're going to want to know about the most innovative form of creatine delivery on the market today, HiGear from Metrex.
HiGear has revolutionized the delivery of creatine by complexing it to a unique carbohydrate source produced by a patented process that has been designed to accelerate the delivery of molecules from the intestine into the bloodstream.
Now I can use creatine without, you know, any discomfort in my stomach.
Significant amounts of fructose and sucrose have been deliberately excluded from the HiGear formulation because they can add unnecessarily high osmolality, which impairs the rapid absorption characteristics of the formula.
If I want all that sugar, I go to a local candy store on the corner.
Only HiGear gives you the revolutionary edge of high-tech rehydration.
Having a physician as respected as Dr. Scott Conley makes a big difference in my choice of choosing a product.
HiGear from Metrex.
Finally, the ultimate breakthrough in sports bar technology, Pure Protein from Worldwide Sport Nutrition, the first high-protein, low-carb nutrition bar ever developed. Pure Protein is the only bar packing 33 grams of protein with only 9 grams of carbs. Call now and order your box of 12 bars for only $39.95.
Pure Protein, the complete meal in a bar from Worldwide Sport Nutrition. Available at select GNCs, health food stores, and gyms worldwide.
For the latest in bodybuilding event coverage, sanctioned by the National Physique Committee and the International Federation of Bodybuilding, Muscle Sport USA recommends the following reading. Muscular Development Magazine, available at all GNC stores and newsstands across the USA. Women's Physique World, the magazine that portrays the beauty of female muscle, available at newsstands nationwide.
Welcome back, bodybuilding and fitness fans. I'm Tom Twilliger, along with Steve Stone, bringing you the action from the Twin Lab NPC Southern States Bodybuilding Championship from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And we have reached the summit of the women's competition with our lightweight, Joyce Bernier, our middleweight in the middle, Kelly McCluskey, and our heavyweight, Debbie Bryant, on stage now to battle it out for the overall title.
Well, Debbie, you can see when she turned around, she's a little bit soft. Tommy, I think that's why Kelly McCluskey will walk away with this title. Look at her. She stands poised, like you had mentioned earlier. She just knows how to show that physique. And besides, when you have that kind of physique, what's not to show?
She is certainly very aesthetic in terms of her appeal. Look at those abdominals right there in the middle. Fabulous. All of the women, of course, have fabulous abdominals.
In order to get this far into the competition, you have to have strong points. The fact that Kelly has them all, great conditioning, she's very sharp. Debbie has the size, like I said earlier, she just needs to be a little sharper. And Tommy, she goes out of her way to look small. Being a heavyweight, she needs to broaden out those shoulders when she stands.
I would think as big as she is, she would be up front taking over that stage. She's really sort of shy over in that corner, maintaining position. Here it is, the audience is ready now. And it is called, there it is, Kelly McCluskey, our middleweight, now the overall champion of the Twin Lab NPC Southern States Bodybuilding Championship.
Giving her a trophy is Tammy Simpson, one of Florida's elite bodybuilders. Kelly looks fabulous. She should definitely consider going on to a national competition. Maybe not this year, but definitely in the near future. She's ready. Tommy, you've been there. What would your advice be to her?
Well, number one, she looks fabulous here today. A lot of bodybuilders make the mistake of changing a winning game plan. Don't try and come in bigger. Don't try and come in harder. Maintain what got you this far, and you'll do fabulous. That's the training advice she needs. Let's take a look at what's happening on stage now with the first of our fitness competitors. Slightly different athletes than what we saw earlier in the bodybuilders. Although they use bodybuilding techniques, let's take a look at the routine that really makes the difference.
Who we're looking at right now is 25-year-old Lynn Cole. She's 5'3", 117 pounds. Tommy, you're absolutely right. Routines do make a huge difference. 33% of it, to be exact. Two-thirds of your score definitely is in the physique, and you can see why Lynn has made our telecast. She looks fabulous here tonight.
Let's move on to our next competitor in the fitness round, Amy Morris, 115 pounds at 26 years old. Although weight doesn't really bear any significance in fitness, does it, Steve? There are no weight classes.
No, everyone competes as one group. Fitness, that's it. It's the physique that counts. You can be any weight, any height, but the judges will critique you as strict as they do a bodybuilder.
Now, we're not seeing a lot of flips and gymnastic moves like we see in many of the other fitness competitions.
The judges will not deduct points if you don't perform gymnastics moves.
Well, certainly Amy Morris had no points deducted as she walks off with the NPC Southern States Fitness Championship title.
And our first runner-up goes to beautiful Lynn Cole.
Moving on to a new category introduced by the NPC. Very few competitions are actually holding this category yet, but I think it's going to start to take off like gangbusters, which is the men's fitness competition. And our first finalist is Manuel Mayer. He's 27 years old, 204 pounds, if you can believe it. This guy is lean and athletic.
Well, he's a former U.S. Marine paratrooper. Men's fitness, only because of this competition, Tommy, may take off. The reason I'm saying that is because these athletes are just that. They're kind of pseudo-bodybuilders, pseudo-gymnastics. There is no real criteria for men's fitness since this is an exhibition sport as of now. But you can see here, they look unbelievable. Our next competitor up is Silk Manning. Here he is. He is in the light heavyweight bodybuilding category. He's unbelievable. Look at this physique. He should definitely go into the team universe as a bodybuilder, and yet here he is today in the fitness competition.
It's not just his physique that makes him outstanding. Look at the energy and the moves going on here. Now, this is truly entertaining, as well as a great display of muscularity and athleticism.
The athletes that we are seeing here are definitely making a statement.
And the winner of the first NPC men's fitness competition on the East Coast, Silk Manning.
A very close contest, in second place by 3 points, Manuel Mayer. Still holds true that two-thirds of your score is your physique. That's why Silk is up here and he looks unbelievable.
Fantastic. Coming up next on Muscle Sport USA, the men's bantamweights.
Whether your muscle is strong or sexy, Nutrimet and Lean Gainer make your nutritional choice champion. A delicious and convenient meal when you don't have time to prepare a meal. Use Nutrimet and you'll notice a dramatic increase in energy and a leaner, healthier body. Lean Gainer is the world's first low-calorie gainer. If building muscle does it for you, then Champion Nutrition, makers of Nutrimet and Lean Gainer, is your pathway to glory.
The muscle boats of Florida, majestic and relaxing. Well, there's nothing relaxing about the muscle inside the War Memorial Auditorium at this year's Twin Lab NPC Southern States Bodybuilding and Fitness Championship. The first competitor in the men's bantamweight division is George Gibson, 38 years old, 140 pounds at 5'4".
We had seen George compete earlier this year when he took third at the Junior Nationals, and you could see here why. He has an unbelievable physique. It's definitely top national quality. The only thing that ruins it, Tommy, is the symmetry, and it's not his fault.
Well, what he has done with this physique is absolutely amazing. Let's hear his story from George himself.
Well, I've been competing since 1981, so I have a lot of experience in competing. I love competing, and I have an injury that I received from a young age of 6 years old, osteomyelitis in the right hip, and that have motivated me to even train harder to be better than my competitors in order to do well in competing.
George personifies the guts and determination that bodybuilding is all about. Our next competitor in the men's bantamweight division weighed in today at 143 pounds at 5'5". This is 27-year-old Roberto Rosales.
Roberto looks good. He has good genetics. You can see it in his girth, his symmetry. Tommy, I'd like to see him move up to the lightweight class because in order for him to move up, he'd have to put on more muscle. That would definitely take him out of this class, but he is holding his own here today.
This gentleman would like to go home with the trophy. In fact, he's going to the same home. They come from the same address. This is Harold Rosales, 22-year-old brother of our last competitor. He weighed in today at 140 at 5'6", a little tall for a bantam, wouldn't you say, Steve?
At 5'6", 140 pounds, definitely. In a regional show, you can get away with it. At a top regional like this one is, you can't. You can see his legs need to be a little bigger. He should move up past the lightweights eventually, Tommy, and almost into the middles at that height.
With only 1 year of training behind him, I'm sure as he puts more time and effort into it, he will move up. Let's take a look at all three of our finalists in the men's bantamweight division.
In the blue, all the way on the right, is George Gibson, followed by the Rosales brothers, Roberto and Harold. Tommy, you can see here, George has the muscle. And if it wasn't for that bad leg, I'm sure he'd probably even move up to lightweights also.
I'm quite surprised, frankly, that he can't move up either way because the muscle in his upper body is absolutely fabulous. I mean, the guy looks great up there. The brothers will try and take George down, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen. And here it is. George Gibson takes home the men's bantamweight division. The Rosales brothers battle it out and wind up second and third. George will be back later on to pose down for the overall title. Let's move on to the men's lightweight division as the middleweights are backstage pumping up. The lightweights are about to storm on stage and we've got a fabulous lineup of competitors.
During the pre-judging, Tommy, these lightweights definitely looked fantastic. You never know who's gonna win the overall title at these events.
Look at these guys. It's so deceptive to see these competitors on stage side by side. They don't give away any idea of how tall they are. They look like massive human beings up there. Our first finalist in the men's lightweight division is Orlando Fontanez, 24 years old, weighed in today at just about the top of the class, 154 and a quarter pounds at 5'5½".
As a lightweight, Tommy, he is very good. Needs to fill out a little bit more. You can see he needs a little bit more muscle in that back. But overall, good symmetry. He has good muscle bellies. I like the package. It just needs a little bit more maturing.
He's got a lot of big muscles, but I think the biggest thing is his smile. I mean, he's really enjoying himself up there. And that certainly brings to life the audience as well. They want to see that this is fun as well as competitive.
When you're that good, it's easy to smile.
Coming all the way down from Memphis, Tennessee for today's competition, our next competitor pushes the ceiling on that height ratio you were talking about at 5'6" and 154 pounds. This is 35-year-old Anthony Moore.
You can see Anthony Moore is in unbelievable condition, probably after the prejudging, in contention to win this lightweight class. But Tommy, like I was saying, at the national level, Anthony could be a middleweight. He has good structure, good solid frame. He could pack on a lot more meat if he wants to.
Our last finalist in the men's lightweight division has our other competitors by at least 10 years. This is 45-year-old Jose Acevedo.
Jose looks very good, Tommy. He's in great condition, shows a lot of muscle. What he doesn't have is that very fluid package. His symmetry isn't as sharp as Anthony Moore's. That's the only thing separating them. Other than that, Jose looks great.
It's amazing that Jose has only been training for 3 years. He's really just getting into this thing.
A lightweight finalist from right to left, Orlando Fontanez, Anthony Moore. And there you have Orlando jumping in between Anthony and Serafin Nieves. And there, John Holzman. To far left, we have Jose Acevedo.
Steve, quite frankly, it's surprising that these guys have enough energy left to really go head-to-head like this.
Well, during the pose-down, Tommy, they know it's a lot of fun. They're going to have a good time. This is the last time they're going to be seen together. And actually, it's the first time a lot of the audience has actually seen them side-by-side, so they want to put on a good show.
Well, I've been excited to see the results of this competition since earlier today because the competition has been real tough.
Well, you're absolutely right, Tommy, and we're getting close to that decision.
Well, they certainly are. There it is, the winner of the men's lightweight division, Anthony Moore.
In second place, Jose Acevedo. Third, Orlando Fontanez. Fourth, Serafin Nieves. And fifth, John Holzman.
When we come back, it gets even thicker with the men's middleweight division on Muscle Sport USA.
Hardcore muscle needs hardcore sports nutrition. Get it with Amerifit's ProTol 170 and Stack 6, the next generation of muscle-building products with cutting-edge nutrients such as DHEA, HMB, yohimbine, pregnenolone, creatine monohydrate, glutamine peptides, and more. These products are as serious as you want to be. For more information or to place an order, call 800-722-FIRM. That's 800-722-3476. If it's hardcore, it's Amerifit.
Why choose designer protein? Not because bodybuilders have made it the number one selling protein powder in America today. Not because it was voted best tasting in an independent study. Choose it because designer protein is the only pure protein powder with WPH whey peptides, delivering up to 230% more nitrogen to your muscles and doing it up to 257% faster. These are the facts. Pick up your designer protein at GNC and other Progressive health food stores and gyms.
Some of the athletes of today's event enjoying the sunshine of warm Fort Lauderdale. Of course, the heat goes up when they re-enter the War Memorial Auditorium to continue to compete in the Twin Lab NPC Southern States Bodybuilding and Fitness Championship. Hi, I'm Tom Twilliger, along with my partner Steve Stone, and we are excited to move into the men's middleweight division of our bodybuilding competition with our first competitor, 24-year-old Todd Vignola.
Well, 2 years ago, he was second place in the middleweight division at the East Coast Championship. He's right at the top of the weight class, so you know he's improved significantly, Tommy, in musculature and condition.
Well, he's definitely in condition. Look at the shape of that body as well. The next finalist in the men's middleweight division is 32-year-old Tony Brown. Now, Tony looks more like a heavyweight up there. Very, very deceptive.
Tony has excellent shape. 5'7", 174 pounds. He's 2 pounds off the max for this weight class. Tommy, he has everything it takes. And after seeing that earlier prejudging, you would have to say he's in the contention for winning this class. And if he takes the class, the overall.
12 years of training. The guy has the muscle maturity it takes to win this and a national competition. I don't know who in this class is going to stop him, except perhaps this man. Milton Berry, at 31 years old and 11 years of training behind him, also has that muscle maturity. Steve, what do you think about the weaknesses on this man, if you can find any?
Well, his symmetry for one. I kind of like Tony's symmetry a little bit better, but you have to say he's packed with rock hard, dense muscle. It's gonna be a very tough call on the judges, but if you like this physique, he'll win this and probably the whole show. If you don't, you'll probably put him in third or fourth.
As the muscular Milton Berry finishes up his routine, he'll be joined on stage by the other finalists in the men's middleweight division. And here they are filing on. This is going to be tough, I think, Steve, between Milton Berry, obviously very muscular and dense, and Tony Brown with that shape and symmetry.
Then we have Milton Berry jumping right up front, standing next to Christopher Blake. Chris looks good, but Milton's thick. You can see it right here when he hits his front lat spread. He's being chased by Tony Brown right there. And you're right, Tommy. Tony is more aesthetic. It's going to be a very tough call.
I think my vote is going to have to go with Tony Brown for that reason. I like the aesthetic shape. I called it wrong, Steve. Milton Berry takes the men's middleweight division.
In second place, Tony Brown. In third, Todd Vignoli. Fourth, Nigel Guerrero. And fifth, Christopher Blake.
Men's middleweight's a tough division with a tough winner who will be hard to beat later on in the pose down for the overall title.
I do agree with you, Tommy, because this middleweight class was that tough. If it's any indication on how the light heavies and heavies are going to look, this overall pose down will be a real barn burner.
Steve, the light heavyweights are now taking the stage, and we have a fabulous lineup of competitors. They've come from all over the region to win this competition because they know taking this title to the national championships will give them a lot of recognition and momentum going into that contest.
Well, entering any contest after winning the Southern States, it's been around for so long, Tommy, and it has such a recognition as being a top regional contest, there's no question about it.
Well, what makes it a top regional competition is athletes just like this. At 5'8", 198 pounds, 25-year-old Frank Diaz really looks fabulous.
Frank was the overall winner at the South Florida Championships. He's very complete, very good symmetry, could be a little thicker. I like him, Tommy. I think he can go far. And after seeing the pre-judging in this highly contested light heavyweight class, Frank is definitely a leader, but the competition doesn't begin or end here for him.
I see it this way. Competition, I compete against myself. On stage, I just show off and have fun.
Bodybuilding does go with you just about everywhere you travel. Our next competitor has some time on the road and time in bodybuilding, 5 years to be exact. Thomas Knight is a certified public accountant as well as bodybuilder. At 28 years old, he's quite accomplished.
It is an accomplishment to place ninth at the Junior Nationals, but I think Thomas can do a lot better, so I don't see that as an end all. He's thick, he's big. As a light heavyweight, he can go a lot further on a national stage.
Our last finalist in the men's light heavyweight division, Dino McAdery, 27 years old, 185 pounds at 5'8". Very sharp, but he looks like a little bit on the lean side, Steve.
Well, he's 5'8", 185 pounds, so he's giving away at least 13 pounds of muscle to the top of the weight class. Here is just the opposite, Tommy. He gave away size for the sharpness. And I'll tell you the truth, I'd rather go with the conditioning. I think the judges favor it.
Dino came all the way from Huntsville, Alabama. Let's see what the judges think of him up against the other four finalists in the men's light heavyweight division.
Silk Manning standing next to Zoltan Sendar. There we have Robert McAdery with Thomas Knight and Frank Diaz.
Frank Diaz and Thomas Knight, two of the thickest men on stage, right there on the end, battling it out, muscular pose for muscular pose.
But you can't leave out the aesthetics and the conditioning of Dino McAdery.
Of course, there's Silk Manning right there. We saw him win the men's fitness competition earlier. Looks like he's in the top five here in the men's light heavyweight division. And there it is. Frank Diaz takes the men's light heavyweight division.
In second place, Dino Robert McAdery. Third, Thomas Knight. Fourth, Silk Manning. Fifth, Zoltan Zender.
Wow, what a great competition. This could have went in almost any direction. I think our light heavy is going to be real tough to beat going into the overall pose down. Flexing a massive bicep, this is Kajana Wren.
Tommy, you have to see in the middleweights, Milton Berry walk away with that title. We thought, hey, how good can this competition be? But we're looking at it. Kajana Wren looks unbelievable. And after seeing the prejudging, he may not even win the heavyweight class. He's big, he's thick, he needs more separation. He may have to stretch more. Whatever it takes to get it, he just needs to split up that thick muscle.
He came all the way from New Orleans. I don't think he wants to go home with anything less than first place. And at 220 pounds, he may just do it. This is Kurt Blair, the man who owns these massive trapezius muscles, traveled all the way from South Charleston, West Virginia, to compete in today's event.
But I don't think that ride was wasted because Kurt could walk away the overall winner of the Southern States. That's right, Tommy. I predict Kurt will probably win the heavyweight class here. He has one more competitor to go up against in Charles Kemp, who is big and massive, but he has it all. And believe it or not, he has a fused lower back, so I give him a lot of credit for getting this condition.
You would never know there was a back injury in this man's physique. Strong abdominals, strong back muscles. Our next competitor is definitely going to rouse this audience when they get a look at the double bicep on 35-year-old Charles Kemp.
Charles is the hometown favorite for this show, and you can see why. He's big, he's massive, he has everything it takes to go on to any kind of level in bodybuilding. What he doesn't have is that sharp conditioning it takes to win this title.
Look at this move, wow! Holy mackerel. If it wasn't for his massive calves, he'd probably get even lower. What really keeps him going is his love for the sport. Let's take a look now at all five of our finalists on stage. Heavyweights indeed. These guys look fantastic.
Then we have Brian Holt standing next to Charles Kemp. In the middle, the man to beat, Kurt Blair. On this end, Jack Osborne standing next to Kurt. Right here in the white, Kajana Ren.
Kajana also looks real good, holding his own up there with the heavyweights. Lots of muscle on these guys. It could go in almost any direction. I'm going to have to go with Charles Kemp, Steve.
On any other day, I would agree with you, but on this day, I'm going with Kurt Blair.
Oh, no, Steve, it looks like I'm 2-for-2 because you called it this time. Kurt Blair does indeed take the men's heavyweight division.
In second place, Charles Kemp. Third, Kajana Ren. Fourth, Jack Osborne. And fifth, Brian Holt.
Wow, Kurt Blair is going to be really tough to beat. We'll see that overall post down when we come back, along with highlights of the NPC Pittsburgh Championship. Right after this.
Welcome again, bodybuilding fans. We're in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania for the exciting NPC Pittsburgh Bodybuilding and Fitness Championships, promoted by none other than NPC Prez Jim Mannion. I'm Kenny Castle. Joining me is the lovely Tina San Antonio.
Thanks, Kenny. It's great being here. After seeing the prejudging, it looks like it's going to be a great competition.
It sure is, and we start with the exciting women's fitness category, and here is our champion, Shelly Loper. Shelly has a gymnastics background, also has an awesome physique. We begin the bodybuilding category with our women's lightweight, and here is our champion, Tracy Tucker.
Kenny, she seems to have thick muscle development. Would that be a function of the style of the training she employs?
Well, I think it does, because she has a powerlifting background, which would build the thickness to her muscles. Also, she's been training for 13 years. Tracy is doing a great job displaying her physique as well. Now we move into our middleweight category, and 6 years of intense training has built a tremendous physique on our winner, Diane Kierzak.
Kenny, her symmetry looks pretty good. How close to perfect would you say it really is?
Well, I would say she has excellent muscular balance and proportions between her upper body and lower body. I'd say where she could improve is she could trim her waist a little bit, get it a little tighter, and also build up her lats and delts a little bit, and then she'll be perfect. Our final category in the women's class is our heavyweight, and here is our champion, Jennifer Doughty.
How much of the edge is taking off the victory when you're the sole athlete in the competition?
Well, it is disappointing because you do want to compete against other athletes. However, if you have pride, you'll want to do the best you can and perform the best for the audience and for the judges, of course, who might see you in later competitions. And now we come to the exciting overall pose down for the women. We see our three competitors, our lightweight Tracy Tucker on the right in green, middleweight Diane Koshinsky in orange in the middle, and of course our heavyweight Jennifer Dowd.
Each weight class is pretty evenly represented.
That is true, but the judges have chosen our lightweight champion, Tracy Tucker. She's done a great job. She looks excellent, she performed well, and she's a worthy champion. We now go into the open men's category, and this competition has produced many past champions who were great. And we start with the bantamweight category, and here is our champion, David Yellowsham. David has tremendous thickness. Look at the lat spread.
Kenny, he's 5'3". Does this present an obstacle for a bodybuilder?
Well, actually not for a bantamweight, because he only weighs 143, and his body is very proportionate. He doesn't look like he's short. Also, one of the top pro bodybuilders in the world is Lee Priest, who is about the same size. Displaying great symmetry and excellent hardness is our lightweight champion, Mike Goodwin.
Kenny, it seems to be a positive benefit to be both a competitor and a gym owner, as Mike is.
Well, it has its good points and also its bad points. For example, you're in the gym all the time, and it makes you kind of burn out from training sometimes. Also, when you're on that pre-contest diet, you get a little snippy. You can't be that way with your customers. Displaying great muscle thickness is our middleweight champion, Joseph Schwamm. Joseph has excellent lower body development. Look at the hamstring and calf development on this guy. His back is very well developed, but it needs a little bit more detail.
His legs are so well developed that it seems to be causing an imbalance between his upper and lower body. Do you think this will hurt him in the pose down?
You try to train for balance, and yes, I think it will give him a problem. Training twice a day, doing cardio in the morning and weight training in the evening, has produced a tremendous physique on our light heavyweight champion, Bill Fedor.
He looks to be in great shape and has unusual vascularity. Could you train to increase your vascularity?
Well, Tina, actually, that's very much a genetic trait. However, if you do high-volume training with a lot of reps, you can increase the vascularity in your physique. Now we move into the heavyweight class, and we always talk about a total package, and our heavyweight champion, Matt McAleer, has that total package. Great symmetry, great proportion, and good muscularity.
Kenny, he believes in getting a broad perspective from a lot of people about bodybuilding. Where have I heard that before?
Yes, well, that's why he uses a very instinctive training and diet system, and it works for him. Now we move into the exciting overall pose down for the men's championship of the NPC Pittsburgh Bodybuilding Championships. We've got five great athletes. They're all in great shape, but I think it's going to be between our light heavyweight, Bill Fedor, as you can see on the right there, hitting the most muscular, and our heavyweight, Matt McAleer. This is going to be a close one. They all look great. And the judges have made their decision. The overall champion of the NPC Pittsburgh Bodybuilding Championship, heavyweight Matt McAleer, here being presented his awards by NPC President Jim Mannion. We'll be right back with more Muscle Sport USA right after this.
Hardcore muscle needs hardcore sports nutrition. Get it with AmeriFit's ProTol 170 and Stack 6, the next generation of muscle-building products with cutting-edge nutrients such as DHEA, HMB, yohimbine, pregnenolone, creatine monohydrate, glutamine peptides, and more. These products are as serious as you want to be. For more information or to place an order, call 800-722-FIRM. That's 800-722-3476. If it's hardcore, it's AmeriFit.
Welcome, bodybuilding fans, to this month's exciting all-natural muscular development magazine with fitness model Denise Paglia on the cover. This month's workout information is all about how to thicken your chest, get chiseled abs, wide shoulders, and bigger arms and legs. You'll also get the latest tips on how to spice up your sex life, plus the dirt about the tiff between superstar Arnold Schwarzenegger and his favorite sport. MD also covers the bases with the most recent information about nutrition, supplementation, profiles on the hottest natural bodybuilders, plus entertainment tidbits meant to provoke your thoughts about fitness. Hot Breaking Research always delivers interesting bits and articles about health and fitness. Recent studies point out that hormones are the reason why women are more prone to acute knee injuries than men. Covering the body with clothing, headgear, and sunblock are the first lines of defense against skin cancer. The second line could be a low-fat diet. State of the Art provides the latest articles about vitamins that fight pollution, pre-exercise carb supplementation, and DHEA. On the web is where your online connection is to the latest in health, sex, nutrition, and news about the bodybuilding elite. If you're looking to boost your sex drive, adding zinc to your diet is just the ticket. Foods high in zinc are turkey, cereals, beans, and of course, oysters. Cigars may be the hottest vice, but 1/2 ounce stogie can generate 7 times as much tar as a cigarette, 11 times as much carbon monoxide, and 4 times as much nicotine. New research shows that a short workout in the gym may alleviate the need for psychiatric help. Though less people work out frequently these days, weight training is still the number one fitness activity, and women are working out in record numbers. If gossip is your thing, look no further than Carol Ann Weber's CyberBuzz column. In the continuing battle between celebrities and the tabloids, Demi Moore and Bruce Willis are suing the star for suggesting their marriage was over and that Moore had a steamy affair with Johnny Depp. Sly Stallone's fans are having trouble dealing with the 40 pounds he gained for his most recent film, Copland, but word has it that he's lost all the weight he had gained. With the help of Navy Captain Connie Mariano, President Clinton has not only rehabbed his knee, but got himself into the best shape he's been in years. In Mentzer Speaks, Mike Mentzer once again provokes your mind by stating that in the context of knowledge, there are no absolutes, and that applies to bodybuilding as well as in life. Intensity in training is one of the major keys to success. Plug 1993 World Natural Champion Kevin Davidson into the equation, and you'll see how intensity is brought to the max. Everyone knows the strength and power required to cut it in the National Football League. Former powerlifting champion John Gamble shares his secrets to hard work, and more hard work. This month's centerfold features exotic fitness model Denise Pagley. Not only does she share her health and fitness tips, but her philosophy of life as well. You'll enjoy this, plus a whole lot more, in this month's all-natural Muscular Development Magazine. Available at newsstands all across the USA.
Thank you, Kenny. Now we're back to the Twin Lab NPC Southern States Bodybuilding Championship.
There we have, all the way to the right, in the teal, George Gibson. In the center right there is our middleweight, Milton Berry. Between them, Anthony Moore, our light heavyweight, Frank Diaz, and heavyweight, Kurt Blair.
These guys are hitting it hard, though. Wow, look at the comparisons. There goes the music. These guys are going to have to muster up a little more energy just to pose down hard. This is their chance to show their very best poses, not the compulsories, and take over the stage with some dynamic personality as well.
Well, you can see here, they all want a piece of this title.
What a job. All right, these guys are going to have to calm down, relax a little bit, like myself. Great competition by all of our athletes today. Of course, only one can go home with the title. Hey, no, this is it. Now, Steve, presenting the trophy, Jim Mannion, president of the NPC. What a fabulous trophy. And there it is. Kurt Blair takes the overall men's championship at the Twin Lab NPC Southern States Bodybuilding Championship. Now let's join Steve Stone to grab an interview with our overall champion, Kurt Blair. Over to you, Steve.
Thanks, Tommy. You called it. Kurt Blair is our overall men's champion. Kurt, that overall pose down was pretty intense. You had the light heavyweight, looked unbelievable. Milton in the middleweights was packed. How did you feel going into it?
Well, just winning my weight class, obviously, I felt confident. But seeing the guys that I was going to be up against for the overall, you know, it made me think a little bit. But I guess, you know, coming out here, you just got to do what you just did and winning your weight class and hope that you come out on top.
Well, Tommy and I had commented during prejudging that the physiques here today are ready for the national stages. You came on top. Where is this going to take you? To the nationals?
Yeah, I plan to hit the nationals in October. You know, I'll take a little time off, a couple days off from the diet and, you know, enjoy life a little bit, and then I'll get back on the training trail and go for it.
Well, I know that last year you did the nationals, but as a light heavyweight, what made you go up to the heavyweights?
Well, for my height, I thought I wouldn't be big enough for heavyweights, and I made the mistake of over dieting for nationals last year, and it just didn't look good on me, so I just went with it and came in and did what I had to do at my weight.
Our audience will not see you until next year. Mm-hmm. Actually, hopefully after the nationals you'll have your pro card.
Yeah.
So we'd like to leave them with one last shot, that front lat spread.
Okay.
Tommy, our overall men's champion, Kurt Blair, back to you.
For information on NPC events, write NPC PO Box 3711, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, 15230, or call 412-276-5027.
Promotional consideration is paid by AmeriFit, makers of the latest revolution in muscle-building nutrients, the dynamic duo of Stack 6 and Protol 170, combining HMB, DHEA, creatine, and many more of the reasons for muscle growth. For free product information on why the future of muscle-building begins here, call 1-800-722-FIRM. That's 1-800-722-FIRM.
Fairmont Hotel of Dallas, Texas, host hotel of the 1996 and 1997 NPC National Bodybuilding Championships. For reservations, call 214-720-5239 or 800-527-4727. Please refer to the event for group accommodations.
Worldwide Sport Nutritional Supplements, a world of difference in sport nutrition. Check out Pure Amino Power, the hottest new supplement available today. For a free product guide and catalog, call 1-800-854-5019.
Sports One Gold Series, the latest game breaker in sports nutrition. For a free catalog and product usage information, please call 1-800-624-8747.
Wanted, dead or alive, champion bodybuilders and fitness athletes, come to Dallas.
General Nutrition Centers present the Advanced Genetics NPC National Bodybuilding and Fitness Championship. Friday and Saturday, October 31st and November 1st, Dallas Convention Center in Dallas, Texas. Feature sponsors Cybergenics, co-sponsors Hammer Strength, Champion Nutrition, Universal Nutrition, AmeriFit, American Bodybuilding, Flex, and Muscle and Fitness. Call 407-876-4467.
For the last 5 years, I've had this dream.
Feed your dream with Twin Lab Creatine Fuel. Creatine Fuel from Twin Lab. Feed your dream. Feed the machine.
Finally, the ultimate breakthrough in sports bar technology. Pure Protein from Worldwide Sport Nutrition. The first high-protein, low-carb nutrition bar ever developed. Pure Protein is the only bar packing 33 grams of protein with only 9 grams of carbs. Call now and order your box of 12 bars for only $39.95. Pure Protein, the complete meal in a bar from Worldwide Sport Nutrition. Available at select GNCs, health food stores, and gyms worldwide.
You can climb a mountain or become one. With new Pinnacle Creaglutide ABS, the next generation creatine supplement. Pinnacle Creaglutide bonds creatine with glutamine peptide for awesome muscle gains. Plus, its patented advanced delivery system extends benefits longer than any other creatine supplement. Pinnacle Creaglutide ABS. Get it in powder or tablets at Great Earth Vitamin Stores, GNC, and other fine health food stores and gyms.
Muscle Sport USA has been brought to you by Twin Lab, makers of creatine fuel and other high-performance sports nutrition products. Feed your dream. Feed the machine with Twin Lab. Designer Protein. Pick up a jar of America's best-selling protein at GNC and other progressive health food stores and gyms throughout all 50 states and Canada. Metrex Engineered Nutrition. Rated number one in bodybuilding nutrition. Metrex is available at fitness and health food retailers everywhere. And by Audionics, makers of Creaglutide with the patented ADS Advanced Delivery System.
Welcome back, bodybuilding and fitness fans. I'll tell you something. If getting off the plane today here in Fort Lauderdale was hot, today's event turned into a steam bath. Steve, sum it up for us.
Well, if you walk away the overall winner of the competition we had seen here today, you are just outrageous. Kurt Blair, Amy Morris, and Kelly McCluskey are all destined to go on to a national level. Congratulations and good luck.
Absolutely. Join us next month, bodybuilding and fitness fans, when we take you to the Big Apple for one of the most prestigious bodybuilding events in the country, the NPC Team Universe Bodybuilding Championship. On behalf of Steve Stone and the rest of the Muscle Sport USA team, I'm Tom Terwilliger. Stay healthy, stay fit.